Now, when the gopis saw Uddhava and his appearance was very much like Shri Krishna, overjoyed, they all gathered around Uddhava. Now, Uddhava's lecture began. He said, there is absolutely no need for you to cry in longing for Shri Krishna. You yourself are the Supreme Brahman. So the gopi said, Uddhavji, if there is only one entity, then whom are you giving a pravachan to? You said, contemplate upon Brahman. With what should we do this contemplation? Uddhavji, we have only one mind and it has gone with Shri Krishna to Mathura. Now this sadhana that you are telling us about, with which mind should we do it? Uddhav was again stumped. Now what to tell them? They say, I don't have a mind. How will they contemplate Aham Brahmasmi? So Uddhav again started pondering now, how to get out of this situation. The gopi said, all right, Uddhavji, let us say that we did have a mind. What is the characteristic of this mind? It is material. Yes, the mind is made from Maya, it is material. And your Brahman is divine? Of course, Brahman is beyond the realm of Maya. So Uddhavji, with this material mind, how will we contemplate upon the divine Brahman? It goes against the Ved mantras themselves. Yan manasana manute yena hur mano matam tadevam brahmatvam vidhi nedam yadidam upasate. It is by the power of Brahman that this mind is able to contemplate. By its own power, the mind can never contemplate upon Brahman. How will we do your contemplation? Uddhav thought, I have got stuck in a really uncomfortable place today. How to save my life? So in the meantime, the gopis discussed. They said, now don't do this to him. After all, he is a friend of our beloved. And Sri Krishna has sent him here. They understood. So the purpose for which he has sent, fulfill it. Bestow grace upon him and let him experience the divine love bliss, premanand of the personal form of God. So one gopi said, Uddhavji, you think that we are crying because we are in separation of God? Yes, it's quite obvious. But Uddhavji, Shri Krishna has not left us. He is right here. Uddhav said, right here. But he sent me off from Mathura to you. How can he be here right now? He is a little teda mera, crooked in his ways. He may have come from some other path running. Where is he? One gopi said, come, let me show you. There, under that kalam tree, Uddhav said, I don't see him. The second gopi said, let me show you. See, he is behind this bush. Again, Uddhav is not able to see. The third gopi says, Uddhavji, Shri Krishna is right here. Now Uddhav cannot understand what is going on. So gopi says, Uddhavji, you will not be able to see him. You are denying the personal form. You are saying God doesn't have a personal form, you are not able to see him. And you think that he has left us and gone? The fact is Uddhav. He cannot leave us for a moment. Wherever we look, we see his form. Vatan me, ghatan me, vithin me, bhagan me. Belin me, vatika me, phoolan me, van me, तरन में दीवारन में देहरी दरीचन में हीरन में हारन में भूषण में तन में कानन में कुंजन में गोपिन में गायन में गोकुल में गोधन में दामिनी में घन में जहां जहां देखूं तह शाम ही दिखाई दे मेरो शाम छाए रहियो नैनन में मन में। उद्धव जी, wherever we look, we see श्री कृष्ण, and you are saying he is in Mathura. उद्धव जी, he doesn't have the ability to leave us. Why? We are abala. See, in abala means without bal, without strength. So in our male-dominated society, historically, women have been called abala. They don't have strength. And that becomes their ingrained psychology also. If some strong woman has to go somewhere in the dark, she'll take a six-year-old boy. Ida, come, hold my hand and go, you are my bal. But Uddhav says, the gopi say, Uddhav ji, we are not that kind of abla as the world thinks women to be. We are abala. Abala. Nobody is as strong as us. You separate the a from abala. So we are abala. Why? Because the supreme, all-powerful God doesn't have the ability to leave us. And that's a fact. Externally, he may be separated. But in consciousness, they are totally and completely united. So the gopis say, Uddhav, this knowledge that you have brought, where will we keep it? In this land of Braj, there is not one empty atom which will be able to accept this knowledge. Because the state of our consciousness is Sham Tan Sham Man Sham Hi Hamar Udhan Sham Sham Ratat सकल ब्रज धाम है श्याम ही ये श्याम जिए श्याम बिना नाही जिए अंधे की सी लाकड़ी आधार श्याम नाम है श्याम ज्ञान श्याम ध्यान श्याम ही हमारो प्राण श्याम श्याम रटत सकल ब्रज धाम है उधो तुम भय बौरे पाती ले आए दौरे योग कहाँ राखे यहाँ रोम रोम श्याम है श्याम तन श्याम मन। सो उद्धव जी सॉ द एलिवेटेड स्टेट ऑफ द गोपीज एंड ही रियलाइज ही वॉज हम्बल्ड ही रियलाइज दैट दीज गोपीज वर एट अ फार डीपर रियलाइजेशन फार मोर परफेक्ट इन योग As Sri Krishna says in this verse. Uddhava was only speaking and saying there is one Brahman. He is everywhere. Salvam khadam khalvidam Brahma. The gopis were actually seeing Lord Krishna everywhere. Chit dekhun tit sham mai hai. That was their godly vision. So Uddhava fell at the feet of the gopis. He said, Krishna had told me to give you knowledge. I now understand what he meant. His indication was, take this baggage of knowledge and throw it at the feet of the gopis and receive from them the gift of divine love, parabhakti. So Uddhav was rolling on the ground. The gopi said, Uddhavji, what are you doing? Such a big gyani, such a big scholar, and we ordinary village women, if people see this spectacle, what will they say about you? Think a little. Uddhav said, now don't ask me to think anymore. I was under great confusion so far. Now I have understood. Hum unke hue ve hamare hue. Uddhav has now come in Dvait. Earlier he was in Advait. I am Brahman. Now he is come in Dvait. Hum unke hue ve hamare hue. इस प्रेम गली में आने से बेकार हमें समझाना है, अब क्या होगा समझाने से. So the gopis bestowed their grace and Uddhav also received parabhakti. Now Uddhav became intoxicated with it. And he started returning from there. He had reached Vrindavan from Mathura in 2 hours. It took him 6 months to reach back. On the way he would embrace every tree, every creeper and scream, Ha Radhe! Ha Shyam Sundar! In that divinely intoxicated state, he reached Mathura. Surdas ji describes, Sur Sham Bhutal Pare Nain Rahe Jal Chai Onchi Peet Pat So Kahyo Bhali Aaye Yog Sikhai. Uddhav and Sri Krishna met, they embraced and they both fell on the ground. Filled with emotion. Both had tears in their eyes. So Shri Krishna with his pitambar, he wiped his friend's tears and said, Uddhav, have you taught yoga to the gopis and come back? Uddhav said, you crooked fellow, you never do anything straight. Why did you not tell me that you are sending me there for this purpose? Shri Krishna said, if I had told you, you would not have gone. This Krishna avatar was such an avatar where God preferred to do everything crooked. Where did the avatar take place? In the jailhouse of Kamsa. Now imagine the master of infinite universes descending. He can descend wherever he likes, but he has chosen to descend in that jailhouse. And the moment the avatar took place, he ran away from the jail as well. All the doors open and Vasudevji took him away. After that, everything crooked. He doesn't even stand straight. That's because he's a rasik shiromani. And the nature of ras is it is crooked. It enhances the ras, like the jalebi is all crooked, but full of ras. So Uddhav said, well, you know, whatever has happened has happened. I want a boon from you. Shri Krishna said, go ahead and ask. Uddhav said, this is from the Bhagavatam. आसामहो चरणरेणु महंस्याम वृंदावने किमपि गुल्मलतौषधीनां या दुस्त्यजन स्वजन मार्य पथंच हित्वा भूत्वा निशे तव पाद पल्लवम. उद्धव सेज, ओ श्री कृष्ण, इन माय नेक्स्ट लाइफ डोंट गिव मी द ह्यूमन फॉर्म. Don't make me a celestial devata. In your land of Braj, make me a little blade of grass. Why? So that residing in that form, I may get the dust of the lotus feet of these gopis. And by virtue of their foot dust, My heart may get purified and the vessel may be prepared so I may also become eligible to receive the kind of devotion that I saw a glimpse of in them when you sent me there. So the Bhagavatam only describes Uddhava's request, but tradition has it that Uddhava actually became a blade of grass. So if ever you happen to go to Vrindavan, on the Parikrama route of Govardhan, you will come to Kusum Sarovar. Recently, just in the beginning of this month, we had a retreat in Vrindavan, Varsana and Mangar, and a lot of people had come from here, so we went to this place as well. There is a temple of Uddhav. So this is a practical illustration of Sri Krishna's declaration that those who are worshipping the personal form reach ultimately a deeper and more perfect state of yoga. However, let us now understand the reason behind this.